Hey everyone, my name is Sebastian and I'd like to talk about notebooks in Visual Studio Code. Not just Pluto notebooks, but general notebook providers and extensions for VS Code, as well as how those might play along with the Julia extension for VS Code. Now, what is VS Code? VS Code is a very extendable Electron-based editor. It's available for all major operating systems and developed by Microsoft under the MIT license, so it's fully open source. I think it's fair to say that VS Code is the most widely used editor in the Julia community, and the extension, the Julia extension for VS Code, is the one with the most development effort poured into. Now, this is a screenshot of how VS Code looks like with the Julia extension installed, and I'd like to give a short overview of the features that you can get from the extension. We provide auto-completions, which are completely statically computed, so they don't depend on the state of your Julia REPL down here. The same is true for the documentation browser over here and the doc strings for the currently selected auto-completion item over here. The documentation pane allows you to search through documentation for every package in your current Julia environment. The outline as well is statically computed from the code in your current editor. But we also provide a bunch of interactive features. For example, the workspace gives you an overview over all symbols defined in the current REPL session, as well as allows you to drill down into modules or structs, etc. We also provide inline evaluation functionalities, which are somewhat notebook-like, in that you can evaluate a block of code, and that code block's result will be displayed inline. It's just a plain text representation. Or in case that a show method with an image or HTML mime type is defined for the object you get, we can also show it in the plot pane over here. Furthermore, we have a fairly feature-complete debugger, even though it might be a bit slow at times. This debugger is based on JuliaInterpreter.jl, much like debugger.jl is. And we have a bunch of nice features here, so you can step through your code, set breakpoints, inspect local and global variables, and even change those. The debug console allows you to execute arbitrary code in the context of the current debugging state. Now, as you can see, the Julia extension provides a bunch of features. Some of those are purely dynamic, so based on the state of the runtime. Others, on the other hand, are statically computable. And this computation happens in the language server, which is a Julia program that inspects your current environment and code to compute information or that can be used for auto-completions or for fetching documentation, etc., etc. This language server is not tied to Visual Studio Code at all. Microsoft has developed a protocol for communication between editors and the language server, called the language server protocol. And this allows other editors to make use of the functionality provided by the language server. So for example, there are Emacs or Vim extensions that provide some of the features that we already have in the Visual Studio Code extension. All right, now most of you are probably very interested in notebooks, so let's talk about those for a bit. And one of the first big notebooks was Jupyter or IPython at the time, which gave you a browser-based interface to language-specific kernels, and it allows you to evaluate arbitrary code and then display the results either as plain text or as rich text or as HTML or as an image. Now, it's not too far-fetched to think about integrating that front end into Visual Studio Code, because VS Code is, of course, a basically browser-based editor, since Electron is just a Node.js runtime. And for that reason, someone wrote a Jupyter extension for VS Code, which you can see here. It supports all the kernels there are, so you can run Julia code in it, you can run Python code in it if you're so inclined. And it's, of course, based on the IPYNB format, which is standard in the Jupyter world. Now, there are some downsides to the current Jupyter extension and its implementation, most notably that it itself is not very extensible, which means that other language extensions cannot contribute any features to it. Furthermore, it also does not use any language server features at all, so most of the cool stuff I've just showed that's available in the core Julia extension is not available. Also, the UI that's implemented is pretty specific to Jupyter and cannot be reused by other notebook formats. So for this reason, the developers at Microsoft have decided to create a notebook API that's available in the core of VS Code, and the Jupyter extension that's shown here, which is only available on VS Code Insiders, makes use of that. It reuses the core editor component that VS Code provides, and is much more tightly integrated with the whole ecosystem. You can see that, for example, hover help is shown when you hover over a function call, for example. And this is provided by Jupyter itself and by the iJulia kernel. But the API that powers all of this is open to other extensions that can just reuse the UI. So even the new Jupyter extension isn't quite what we want. Well, yes, it is based on the new notebook API, it features a shiny new UI, and also it supports Julia out of the box. It is still based on the Jupyter protocol, it still requires iJulia for that reason, and crucially, it does not support any language server-based features, so refactorings or outlines and stuff like that won't work. So for that reason, we over at the Julia extension for VS Code have decided to implement our own notebook, which may or may not be based in a custom file format. It will definitely support IPYNVs, but might also have support for Julia's Viv Markdown, JMD. It'll feature a custom Julia kernel, something that's very, very similar to what's already running inside an integrated REPL, which has support for inline evaluation. So notebook evaluation is something very similar. It will also make use of all the advanced language server features, and we'll get the fancy VS Code editing experience for free. So having this generic API and UI in VS Code Core opens the door for different notebook extensions and different kinds of notebooks. It's very conceivable to have a Pluto notebook using this API in VS Code instead of just a website that's laid in an iframe, which is already possible, but doesn't offer much more over just running Pluto in a browser. It's possible, even though not quite as natural, to have a reactive notebook, which Pluto is, as opposed to Jupyter. And the user experience inside of the provided notebook UI is customizable, but it's not going to be easy to make it super similar to Pluto. The advantage of all of this is that we can make use of language server features, and we can also replicate the rich output that Pluto provides via embedded iframes in this new scheme. It's also possible that we can get the debugger to just run inside of that notebook, which is something that Pluto doesn't have at the moment, and that would also be quite a significant effort to implement. There are, however, quite a few challenges ahead for Pluto integration in VS Code, most notably that the proposed notebook API for VS Code is rapidly changing. It's still only on the insider's build, so you can't even get it on a stable VS Code build. And the Pluto API itself isn't very stable either. There's probably going to be some need for a connection layer because VS Code needs to handle kernel startup and so on and so forth. Currently, that's all handled in Pluto's Julia code. So all in all, it's definitely possible to have Pluto notebooks in VS Code, and it would greatly benefit both projects. VS Code would get a very interactive and reactive notebook, which there is not at the moment, and Pluto can benefit from all the editing features that VS Code provides, as well as the language server features, of course. In case anyone's interested in this slightly ambitious project, we have a project description available at the URL you can see on your screen. We'd love to have you shoot us an email or hit us up on Slack. If no one wants to take up this JSOC project, then I'm sure that Fons and Michael and me will at some point, hopefully, get to that. Thanks, PlutoCon, for having me, and thank you for listening.
All right. Thank you, Sebastian. Let me add everyone. Thank you so much. I mean, this is very exciting news, I think. Nick Paniotis, are there any questions from Molly?
So I think there's no questions on YouTube.
Okay, so I guess so I want to point out again, this is a Google Summer of Code project. So if anyone wants to work on this, both me and Sebastian would be very happy to help. Let's see. I mean, it's difficult to ask questions because I talked about this before.
I can ask a question for me. I fiddled a little bit with a VS Code Notebook API, and then it seemed like it assumed that you are Jupyter all the time. So there were like cell types, and it could be Markdown or code. What do you think about it now? Has it changed? Is it nicer?
Yeah, it's changed quite a bit, actually. There's still an inherent assumption that you have code in Markdown cells, which I don't think is going to go away anytime soon. There also are some assumptions built into that make reactivity a bit tricky. So that's something we'd either have to work around or convince them to change those assumptions, kind of, which isn't or might not be too hard because David Antoff and I are in fairly close contact with one of the main developers for the Jupyter extension. And they have a lot of input on how the API works, basically.
Can you guess, after this would be done, like Prelude inside VS Code, would it be easy to make a reactive notebook for another programming language in VS Code? Or do you think it's not related?
So I think there's definitely some code that could be shared. But ideally, the project would make sure the API is more friendly for reactive notebooks. Let's say that's way. Either that or add a layer on top of the like official API, maybe a node package that makes it easier.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you again, Sebastian. I think this is very exciting. If someone wants to work on this, get in touch. Otherwise, And let's go on to the next talk, which will be teaching finite elements interactively by Max Köhler. All right, thank you.